here. It's happening. iPad for DaVinci Resolve is officially on the App Store. Ignore if you hear my toddlers in the background. It is currently 8:18, and I just got the tweet notification that Blackmagic has launched the app in the App Store, but I wanna show you how to download it if you are like me and you immediately are trying to get it, because a lot of times when apps are initially released, as we can see here, if I go to the App Store, I search DaVinci Resolve, still not showing up here. Of course, they tweeted it out, but I will put it in the description of this video down below, and that is going to take us to the specific spot in the App Store where we can now download it. I first actually am going to remove the test light version, test flight. That way I can start fully from fresh here and see what the download process looks like. Can we get the free version to work? Before I download it, actually, I do wanna point out again, all it says in the description is that it's optimized for M1 and M2 iPads. Earlier, an iPad models with memory limitations have limited functionality available. I've heard things like, if it's not an M device, you're limited to 1080p. I'm sure you're not gonna get a lot of the open effects plugins, maybe noise reduction, the stuff that takes a lot of graphics and processor heavy stuff. Okay, let's go ahead, download the official public release of DaVinci Resolve for iPad. For those curious, while it is downloading, it looks like the size is 2 gigs. So a lot of people were commenting asking, you know, what if I have a 64 gig device? So the app itself isn't taking up a ton of space, and projects don't take up much space at all. Most of the time, your biggest files, which will be the source video files, you will keep on an external hard drive. And so you shouldn't have to worry too much about your internal storage. I'm guessing it's not gonna be that different from the beta version that I've been using in the past couple of weeks. We'd like to use Bluetooth, yes. So in case you have the speed editor. If you've seen my past handful of videos, it looks like this is pretty much the same exact thing. I'm not seeing any new features anywhere. We can sign into my Blackmagic Cloud account and we can see all of my projects just fine. Thing that I'm looking for is the in-app purchase. So I couldn't figure out how to activate the studio version for the in-app purchase, but thanks to Timothy Schultz on Twitter, kind of answered his own question. It looks like to get it activated, all we need to do is do something that is a studio feature. And so I just dragged in a couple random clips here. And if I go under the effects tab, there we go. Okay, yeah, we get this nice pop-up. We can see the watermark over our footage, and we can either restore if we've already purchased it, say on another iPad, not yet, or if we hit purchase, we can see that it options for a one-time $95 charge. To be honest, I love the way that that is set up. So many apps you download, and then as soon as you open it, it hits you with the in-app purchases. But the way that they have designed this, use the app until you need a feature that requires the studio license. So there will be some of you that go to make videos and you will never see this pop up. Or if you do, you'll be like, eh, I didn't really need that effect or plugin or whatever. I love the way that is set up. Once again, A+, Blackmagic. I know I've been using the beta the past couple weeks, but I'm just so excited that finally I can respond to people's comments saying it's available. I secretly was hoping that they wouldn't release this for at least a couple more days. I am finishing up a mini course for anyone who is new to DaVinci Resolve, especially on the iPad. I decided to make a miniature course on it. So if you're new to DaVinci Resolve or you're interested in learning it on the iPad and learning all the ins and the outs, leave a comment down below letting me know you're interested and I will make sure to get it done in a timely manner. Yep, still have noise reduction, can handle 6K B-RAW files just fine. Yeah, so the experience seems basically exactly on par with what we've been seeing in the beta versions. I don't see any new features right off the bat. I don't wanna waste any more of your time. Go download it, enjoy it, and let's all welcome DaVinci Resolve to the iPad. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next video.